Friends, in this session of Information Technology Act, let us learn about the duties of the subscribers. First of all, we have to know who is a subscriber. So normally, in the Information Technology Act, a subscriber is defined as the person who has applied or who has got a digital signature certificate. Otherwise, normally, a person who sends any message is called the originator. Whereas here, particularly in relation to digital signature certificate, a person who possesses the digital signature certificate is called as the subscriber. So how to get the digital signature certificate? The hierarchy I have told you. First of all, there will be a controller and his functions are enshrined in section 18 of the Information Technology Act. He is the person who gives licenses to the certifying authorities, who in turn will give the digital signatures to the subscribers. So the certifying authority has to apply under section 22 and for renewal under section 23 and after inquiry, and also taking into consideration his experience, certification practice statement, financial condition, whether he is able to pay the fee or not. Considering all these things, then only the license will be given to have the to issue the so-called digital signature certificates. Right? So entire the lengthy procedure is if at all somebody the controller refuses, they should give it in writing and they have to take the explanation, and then only they can consider all the things we have discussed. So as far as digital signature certificate is concerned, normally according to section 35, any person can make an application for getting the digital signature certificate, and he has to pay the prescribed fee, he has to fill up the prescribed form and all these things, and after conducting a due inquiry, then they will give the so-called digital signature certificate. Right. So please remember, the very purpose of the digital signature certificate is the purpose of the IT Act itself, the Information Technology itself, to legally recognize the electronic documents on par with of the white paper documents. Main purpose is IT Act వచ్చిన కారణం ఇదే. ప్రీవియస్ గా మనకి ఏదైనా రికార్డు కావాలి అంటే, ఏదైనా డాక్యుమెంట్ కావాలి అంటే అది ఆన్ పేపర్ ఉంటేనే, ఇన్ రైటింగ్ ఉంటేనే ఒప్పుకునేవాళ్ళు. అది కాకుండా ఇన్ పేపర్ కాదు, ఎలక్ట్రానిక్ కమ్యూనికేషన్ కూడా సరిపోతుంది అని చెప్పడానికే ఈ యాక్ట్ అంతా చేయటం వచ్చింది. అలాగే రెండవది, సహజంగా ఏంటంటే టెక్నాలజీ డెవలప్ అవుతుంది కాబట్టి ప్రభుత్వం కూడా ఈ గవర్నెన్స్, పేపర్లెస్ గవర్నెన్స్ అన్ని పెట్టినాయి కాబట్టి దాని ప్లేస్ లో ఎస్ ద డాక్యుమెంట్స్ సెంట్ ఎలక్ట్రానికల్లీ దే షుడ్ బి అడ్మిటెడ్ ఇన్ ఎవిడెన్స్. దిస్ ఈస్ వెరీ పర్పస్. రైట్. తర్వాత నౌ 35 ప్రకారం అప్లికేషన్ పెట్టుకున్నాము, ప్రొసీజర్ ఉంటుంది, డెఫినెట్లీ దే విల్ గివ్ ద సో కాల్డ్ డిజిటల్ సిగ్నేచర్. డిజిటల్ సిగ్నేచర్ అనేది ఆల్రెడీ మీకు చూపించాను ఒకసారి. నార్మల్లీ ఇట్ విల్ బి ఇన్ ద షేప్ ఆఫ్ నోట్ లైక్ మనకి ఓకే. సో ఇట్ విల్ బి ఇన్ ద షేప్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ పెన్ డ్రైవ్. రైట్. So to get it, all the procedure. Now after getting it, what? So please remember, whenever any digital signature certificate is given, it will have two keys. One is a private key and the other one is a public key. Private key anaga emi, private key mee daggare untundi, it is an individual key. Ante mee danni system lo pettagane automatically a private key jarugutte okkaru unna sar generate cheyamante private key change chesukochu, ini mee ishtam. Another key is called the public key. So public key will operate. No doubt, my private key operation is the main channel. You are not sure whether I am the person who is sending this so-called digital signature certificate permission. Neena kada check cheskoranga anumanam. Appudu double checking kosam, cross checking kosam, the other person will ask the public authority, certifying authority. Vaallu public key istaru. ఆ పబ్లిక్ ఇచ్చిన తర్వాత ఈ ఎట్స్ ఆ పబ్లిక్ కీలో ఉన్నటువంటి ఏదో హ్యాష్ LP0356 ఏదో చెప్పాను కానీ ఓపెన్ అయితే 100% డబ్ల్యూ షూర్ దట్ యూ హ్యావ్ సెంట్ ది సబ్స్క్రిప్ మెసేజ్. సో ప్రైవేట్ కీ అండ్ పబ్లిక్ కీ, బోత్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్ ఆర్ ఇంపార్టెంట్. నౌ coming to our point, Pradhanku both Khatana Zaripayandi, what are the duties? They are enshrined in section 41 to 43. 41, generating the key pay. Normalga, Tiskuni, subscriber, Ichintarava, the settling alert, the Grinch, subscriber garu, key pay, lakwante, private key, Margistadu, Kispismatarava, that name. Puja Mandala Betti Puja, you have to start it, you have to check up whether it's functioning or not. That's what is called generation. So, we have to generate the key pair using the security procedure. 100% most important section 41. So, 40. 40 yellow, the same procedure applies to electronic signature certificate also. 41, generate chesa. Chesa anta matra, meek already section 11, 12, 13 paper. Attribution, acknowledgement, dispatch, and receipt. This is now attribution. Second, how do you say that it has been started? For that, you have to accept the digital signature. How will you accept means you have to send it to one or more persons. Generating lo, yes, second point, you have to send it to one or two more persons or you have to send it to your repository. Just like the certificate that they have not the correct kada check. Then by that, if they accept it, the subscriber holds the private key corresponding to the public key. Man negre one ye. Alage, repotane the Ostra Chinabu, setting the key, gives us the other, Rasnabu. Yes, Mr. So-and-so person, this is the subscriber has sent this message. Alage, whatever message you send to any person, it is within the knowledge of the subscriber, that is presumption. So, me yokka private key use chesi vella message mattamu meeru pampichinatte. That is the presumption. So, within your knowledge, adi matram gurtu pettukondi. Then, 42. This is most important. Please have control of the private key. There is no other alternative. Meeru matram private key ni vere evariki ivvakapodadu. ఇచ్చిన ద్వారా నష్టం కూడా ఆల్రెడీ మీకు ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ చేశాను. సో పేరు చెప్పడం బాగలేదు కానీ, వన్ గర్ల్ షీ వాజ్ బోర్న్ ఆన్ 17/8/1979 ఇన్ ఎ పర్టికులర్ ఏరియా ఇన్ ఎ టౌన్. బట్ వెన్ హర్ 10th క్లాస్ సర్టిఫికేట్ ఇన్ హర్ 10th క్లాస్ సర్టిఫికేట్ ఇస్ మెన్షన్డ్ యాజ్ 17/8 సో సో డేట్. Now the same date, the month is changed because she has to cross the 15 years age at the time of appearing for the 10th class examination, which happened. So she is under the impression that her date of birth is 17/8 so and so, but her original date of birth is 17/3. So while applying for the passport and visa, all these things, she was asked to produce the date of birth certificate from the place where she was born. But here the record is 17/3. Right, there is a confusion whether to add. If she says that it is 17/8, false. If it is 17/3, first information, the second information will be false. So, they have managed. How they managed? They approached the computer clerk or computer operator of the said municipality, managed him, and he typed as 17/8. The person, the municipal commissioner, who was not well aware and who has handed over the private key to the so-called computer operator, simply signed and later on filing of a petition by the opponent party, he was involved and placed in the suspension. Please remember, Kabatti, meerandaru private keys mee daggare pettukovali. Very recently in our neighboring mandal, Santaruthapadu mandal lo kuda, oka MPDO candidate, MPDO, he was also involved in trouble because of this only. He handed over the private key to the computer operator while attending a video conference with the CM, and there he has stated that he has given license to some 75 litterans or something. So he has asked them to fill up the names. This boy filled up his own names and he has drawn the money. Ultimately, he was taken to trouble. Please remember, never ever hand over the private key to the any other person. But things will not be like that. There may be some change. So let us control of the private key. Every subscriber shall exercise control over the. So please remember, reasonable care and reasonable care to retain control of the private key. You have to take reasonable care. Why I am telling you? Suppose you are going in a bus to this Sankranti festival. It was very heavy. You are carrying the private key in your pocket, but somehow it is missed or somebody comes at the top. That's why you can't have 100% care. Reasonable care to retain control is more important. Right? What to do? Suppose whatever message you send, through this so-called private key, it is deemed that the subscriber has done the same. But if something it is lost, what you have to do? Immediately, when you come to know that it is compromised, that somebody has managed it, or somebody has taken it, somebody has used it without your knowledge, immediately you have to give information to the certifying authority. From that time, yes, they will cancel it, no transactions can take place. But before that time, whatever happened, definitely, you will be held liable. Please remember, without any delay, you have to inform the certifying authority that your signature has been compromised. Finished. Yes, they will take care of it. Suppose there is a doubt from a boy. Suppose if there is a delay, suppose at the particular time he may not be able to know if there is a delay, then whenever he comes to know of the so-called compromising of the key, immediately he has to inform. But please remember, till such day some transaction took place and the court or the controller will verify whether they are genuine, whether they are false. If they are false, they will get it annulled. If not, you will be penalized. Please therefore remember these three sections, duties of the subscriber. To be frank, it is very easy to remember, but to be in practical things, to be in practically maintaining all these things may be difficult. Anyway, Section 40 says you have to generate the key pair. Section 41, you have to accept the digital signature. And Section 42 says about the control of the private key, which is most important. You have to follow all these guidelines. They are your duties, not only. You have to follow them. There is no other goal. Thank you.